Assalamu alaikum. This tutorial we are going to talk about. In this tutorial, we're going to talk about operations in general. We have a lot of different types of operations, but we are going to start with arithmetic operations. I'm going to talk about arithmetic operation. Arithmetic operation is an operation between two operand, two or more operand. One of the examples of it is we have plus sign, we have minus, we have division, and we have modulus. That is, this modulus will return the reminder for your operation. Assume you say 10 divided by 3. We know the answer is 3.333 like that. But if you perform this modulus, it will return, it will only give you, it will just return the reminder. So if you divide 10 into 3, you're going to have 3 threes, then the reminder is 1. So it's just going to return what they find the remainder, which is 1. And we have multiplication. These are the examples of the arithmetic operation we're going to talk about. And remember, for the multiplication, you can use bracket. Bracket also stands for example, operations, for multiplication. So assuming that we have a variable, let's say, let's clear this one and declare our variable, let's say int a and b, and you have your c. So you can collect, you can, let's say a is equals to console.readline. But in this case, we're going to have an error if you are to just type it like that, because console.readline is a string, but we have already declared our variable as a what? As an integer, or a is an integer. So since this one is a string, we have to convert this one into what? Into integer. So we say int dot parse, we store this string into this. So now we're not going to have any error. So our a will hold, will come, the string from the input will be converted into integer and be stored into a. So we should come the same thing. Well, another way to convert, we can say convert dot to int 32, then we put our console dot read line, then we put this. So now we have our a and b. So c can be equals to, c is equals to a plus b. So now we can come and say now console dot read line, we display our answer, say summation of a and b is equals to c plus what? But in this case, we have to just plus c. We display our result. So finally, if we a is 1, b is 1, we're going to see c equal, we're going to have c equals to 1 plus 1, which is 2. So finally, we're going to summation of a and b is equals to what? C. So, but why are we having this error, for example? Remember, this is our c is an integer. Our C is an integer, but since the C++, I said C#, I mean it's a case sensitive, so we need to use our small c, not capital C. So now, if we run our program, arithmetic operation, let's say A is 1 and B is 3, the result is going to be 4. So A 1 plus 3 equals to 4. This is for arithmetic. But if we are to perform the minus operation, so at the same time, we can say 3 for let's say 2 minus 1, the result is going to be 1. But assuming we are going to do multiplication, integer multiplied by integer is going to give us integer. If you add integer with integer, the result is integer. You subtract integer from an integer, it's going to be integer again. So let's say 3 times another times 5, making 15. So in whenever you are going addition, subtraction, multiplication, you can work with integers. So the where you are storing your value can be integer. But if we are to perform division, certainly if we divide A by B, you might have a remainder or a fraction. So in that case, advisably is to declare C to be of double type. So let's say double C. So in that case, C equals to A divided by B. So we can have our result and say, let's say A is 10 and B is 5. We can have 2. At the same time, if we are to say now a is 3 divided by 1 divided by 2, we are going, oh sorry, I made a mistake, it's supposed to be a whole number, not a fraction. let's say 3 divided by 2, we're going to have 1 again. The reason is that whenever you divide an integer with another integer, you're going to have a result integer. So in that case, at this juncture, you have to do what is called explicit conversion. So you convert your integers into double. So double divided by double, you're going to have a double. So, but whenever you divide integer with an integer, you're going to have an integer. That's why we are having 1 instead of 1.5. So now, if we run, let's say 3 divided by 2, we're going to see have 1.5. So whenever you want to perform an operation like multiplication, and you know your operand are integers, make sure you perform an explicit conversion to convert all the integers into double and perform your division. So now, but if we are to perform the modulus operation, we said modulus returns what do you call it, reminder. So now if we say 3 divided by 2, we're supposed to be 1, reminder will be what? So 1. So if we're going to divide 3 into 2, you have 1, it will take away 2 from 3, you have what left? 1. So it's going to return only reminder out of that. And again, whenever you're performing arithmetic operation like in normal mathematics, the rules for that rule for mathematics, that is Bodmer's, is applied. So assuming you have a multiplication, addition, subtraction, it's going to start with a bracket, then division, multiplication, the addition, and finally subtraction. So remember, whenever you are performing, assuming you are performing operation also like addition, let's say, let me just put A and B here all together. In this case, it's going to give us an error, because you are saying string, you add it with string, you add it with another string. And it's better to put this into bracket. So it's going to do the mathematics, then later returns the result together with your string. So we are going to have equals to 3. But if we are to remove this bracket, we are going to have a different scenario. It's going to have our result is what? Summation of A and B will be equals to 21. Because it's going to concatenate A and B, then concatenate with our string, which is summation of A and B. So whenever you're performing mathematical operation, make sure you obey the Bodmer's rule by putting bracket here, since we don't want it to be concatenated with a string. So this is for the arithmetic operation. The next operation we're going to talk about is logical. So assuming we copy this one and say whenever we're done with the arithmetic operation, we come and say logical operation. So for logical operation, we have AND, we have OR, and we have NOT. But in C#, so I'm sorry about these errors, we are going to tackle them. I'm just demonstrating. And in C# is you put double ampersand. For O, you put this vertical lines, and for NOT you put exclamation mark. So assuming we have a variable of type bool, will let's say q equals to true, then you have s bool s, and s equals to false. So, and finally we have, let's say, bool t, then to have a value of t, you can perform either AND operation, OR operation, or NOT operation, that is negation. So if I say now t is equals to q and s, so for AND operation, when both the operands are true, you're going to have true. If both the operands are false, you're going to have false. Addition is just like a multiplication. 1 times 0, assuming 1 is true, 0 is false. So 1 times 0, definitely, you're going to have what? 0. But if you have 1 times 1, you're going to have 1. 0 times 0, you're going to have 0. So if both the operands are true, you're going to have true. But if both either of the operands are false, you're going to, the result is going to be what? False, of type of false. So finally, let's say console to display our result. Dot write line. We open a bracket. Our result is, so percentage, we concatenate it with our with the t. So now let's comment this section. So if we run it, the result is going to be false because q is true, s is false. Finally, we're going to have a false. That is for our result for AND operation. But if we are to perform for OR operation, let's say we have another variable u, say u is equals to q o s. Remember, for AND we say if both the operand are true, you are going to have true, otherwise you are going to have false. But for the O is like plus sign. If either of the operand is true, the final result is going to be true. But if both operand are false, the result will be is going to be false. So let's say here we output our u. So if we run it, we are going to have true for. Sorry, let me make a space here. Create a space here. So if we run again, we are going to see for the AND we have false, and for the OR we have true because S is true. Finally, we are going to have what? Since S is Q is true, we are going to have true. But finally, for NOT, let's say since our T is for S is false, let's say NOT S. That is NOT S. We negate our value of the value of S. So our result of NOT. So our result for NOT is going to be true because we are negating what? We are negating S, and S is false, so our output is becoming true. This is for logical operation. And the last one for the relational, I'm going to save it for the next video. Thank you for watching.